We share Waliu.
My name is
You are welcome and take your seat.
I represent the very good people, hospitable people of Gusu Federal Constituency, Mr. Speaker. I'm an Ijoma from Delta State. My motion is on the ravaging flood in the Ijoma community of Delta State. The House notes recent report in the nation's media and the outcry of communities in Gusu Federal Constituency on the devastation wreaked on them by heavy floods from River Niger and the surging waves from the Atlantic Ocean. The House observed that following the floods, which had been happening intermittently in the past 6 months, a number of valuable public and private properties have been destroyed, hundreds of people displaced, and economic activities disrupted. The House also notes that the flooding of this year would not have been as severe as it was if the government had taken steps to construct suitable shoreline protection levees, as had been advocated severally in the past by professional environmentalists. Concerned, Mr. Speaker, that the people of the affected communities now live in fear of the likelihood of more floods with accompanying displacement of yet more people and the outbreak of communicable diseases. The House is better to resolve. 1, call on the executive branch of government to provide funds in 2017 budget estimates for the construction of shoreline protection levees in the coastline, especially in Delta State, that appears to bear the brunt of the annual fury of the River Niger and ocean waves. 2, all the Federal Ministry of Environment, Works, Power and Housing, and Niger Delta and the Niger Delta Development Commission, NDDC, to consider joint action to reconstruct the damaged public buildings, such as hospitals and schools, and also to assist residents to rebuild their damaged homes. 4, mandate the Committee on Environment and Habitat to undertake an assessment visit to the communities and make recommendations on remedial measures that can be taken to obviate future occurrences of flooding in the community, and report back to this House within 6 weeks for further legislative action. Mr. Speaker and honorable members, I so move. Thank you.
Seconder, Honorable Hassan Gombe.
Very direct.
Honorable Shaulu, please.
What do we intend to cure?
Honorable Shaulu, please.
Several communities.
Allow them to their seats.
Is almost being washed away. For instance, if the people of my community, Obotobo 1, for instance, should leave the committee for 2 years, they will not return and meet the committee again. It would have been washed away by ocean. For the past year, what they do is they use local measures by way of contributions from the community to ensure that they can do little protections to secure their community. The speaker will speak. Most of our communities is being flooded. Reptiles have taken over houses. People are scared to return to their houses as it is not habitable. Communities like Gbekobo, Ayakoromo, Obotebe, Tuomo, Tamigbe, Ubagbane, Torogbane, Ojobo, Blundoro, Tobigbe, Obotebo 1 and Obotebo 2 and Inokura are all having similar problems. Mr. Speaker, the content of this motion itself is explicit and self-explanatory. My people are in dire need of assistance from the federal government to ensuring that to cure this immediate one and to ensure that in the future it doesn't happen again. Mr. Speaker, as we speak, pupils could no longer go to schools because the schools are all being affected by the flood. Honorable members, I'm appealing to this House to support this motion and to make provision for the 2017 budget to ensuring that those affected communities, particularly the hospitals and schools, are rebuilt so that the students can go back to school. Mr. Speaker, this is not the first time that we are suffering this fate. I want to also say this by way of comment, that the last time I moved the motion here on the the spill and ask this Honorable House to mandate the federal government by way of NEMA to assist the persons with relief materials. As I speak, for the past 6 months, nothing has been done, and the people are still suffering the same fate. In addition to this one, Mr. Speaker, I want to urge this Honorable House to support this motion and to ensure that my people should be given a facelift from this very devastating and emotional torture they are passing through now. Thank you, Mr. Speaker and Honorable Members, for listening.
Honorable Sergeants.